Hello students, we are going to learn about the topic of optics. Optics means study of light. Many consider as the light as a way then we can understand or study the different phenomena related to the waves. Look at here see the two scientists. These two scientists suggested that the nature of light. He explained the nature of light. The first scientist is Sir Isaac Newton, another is the Huygens. The first scientist Newton suggested that his theory called as the Newton's corpuscle theory. He suggested that the light consists of very tiny elastic rigid particle known as corpuscles. These corpuscles on emission from a source of light travels in straight line with high velocity. When these particles enter the eyes, they produce images of the object or sensation of the visions. Corpuscles of different colors have different sizes. Reflection and refraction of light are because of repulsive and attractive forces. According to the Newton's corpuscle theory, he suggested that the light is a tiny particles and known as the corpuscles. Then he said that corpuscles emits from the source of light and travels in a straight line with high speed. जेव्हा कॉर्पस्कल हे आपल्या आईजमध्ये एंट्रस होतात त्यावेळेस त्या ठिकाणी आपल्या आईजमध्ये जी इमेज प्रोड्यूस होते त्यामुळे आपल्याला त्या ऑब्जेक्टचं सेन्सेशन आहे ते कळत असतं. कॉर्पस्कल्स आहेत हे कॉर्पस्कलचे डिफरंट कलर्स आहेत आणि डिफरंट कलर्स हे कशामुळे आहेत तर त्याच्या डिफरंट सायजेसमुळं. ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन न्यूटन्स ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन द फेनॉमिनॉन रिलेटेड टू द लाईट रिफ्लेक्शन अँड रिफ्रॅक्शन. The demerits of the Newton's corpuscle theory. Velocity of light in denser medium is greater than the velocity of light in rarer medium. Newton suggested that or discovered that the light's velocity in denser medium. For example, if we consider water, the light's velocity is just higher compared to rarer medium. Air peksha. ऑटरमध्ये लाईटची व्हेलॉसिटी जास्त आहे असं न्यूटनने सांगितले. अगेन न्यूटन अनेबल टू एक्सप्लेन द सायमल्टेनियस रिफ्लेक्शन अँड रिफ्रॅक्शन. न्यूटन सायमल्टेनियस रिफ्लेक्शन अँड रिफ्लेक्शन हा एक्सप्लेन करू शकलेलं नाही. ऑल्सो अनेबल टू एक्सप्लेन द पोलरायझेशन इंटरफरन्स अँड डिफ्रॅक्शन दिस फेनॉमिना रिलेटेड टू द लाईट. सायंटिस्ट अनेबल टू फाइंड आउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन द साईज कलर ॲट लार्जर लेवल. Then second scientist was that the Huygens, and Huygens was suggested or discovered his theory called as the low theory of light. In that he suggested that the light is propagated in the form of wave. That means according to the Newton, the light is a corpuscle, and according to the Huygens, light is a wave. These waves are emitted by the source of light and travels in straight line with uniform velocity through the homogeneous medium. He suggested that the waves are emitted by the source of light and travels in a straight line with a uniform velocity and travels through a homogeneous medium. When the light enters our eye, it creates optical impressions on the retina, hence we get the sensation of light. Then he suggested that the different colors are due to different wavelength of light, and light waves are mechanical waves. For propagation of these waves, a hypothetical medium called the luminiferous ether is present everywhere. Light travels through ether in the form of waves. त्याने सांगितलेलं आहे की लाईट आहे ज्यावेळेस मिडियममधून ट्रॅव्हल होते त्यावेळेस ते पूर्ण मिडियम आहे ल्युमिनिफेरस इथरनं बनलेलं आहे, नॉट इन अ व्हॅक्युम. म्हणजे त्या मिडियममध्ये व्हॅक्युम प्रेझेंट नाही तर त्या ठिकाणी ओनली ल्युमिनिफेरस इथर आहे आणि त्या ल्युमिनिफेरस इथरमधून लाईट वेव आहे हे ट्रॅव्हल होते. देन merits of the theory of light. The phenomenon like reflection, refraction, polarization, simultaneous reflection and refraction, total internal reflection, diffraction, all these phenomena can be successfully explained with the help of this theory. According to Huygens' theory, the speed of the light in denser medium is less than the speed of light in a rarer medium. This conclusion is in perfect agreement with the experimental finding. Demerits of the wave theory of light. The existence of so-called luminiferous ether assumed by Huygens was not confirmed. ज्याने सांगितलेलं आहे की जे युनिव्हर्समध्ये जे मीडियम आहे ते luminiferous ether आहे. Then after some time he not explained luminiferous ether was not present in the medium. Then rectilinear propagation was not explained by this theory. The light travels along rectilinear propagation. He not explained diffraction was explained so much later. He also explained diffraction but much later on. This theory could not explain photoelectric emission. जेव्हा थेरीच्या सहाय्याने त्याने फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इमिशन हा एक्सप्लेन करू शकलेला नाही आहे. According to the Huygens, there are two types of the sources, primary sources and secondary sources of light. Primary sources, that means those sources that emit the light of their own because of their high temperature. म्हणजे primary sources आहे की त्यांच्याकडे स्वतःची light आहे, स्वतःच light ते emit करतात. Because of their high temperature, त्यांच्याकडे असणाऱ्या high temperature मुळे त्याला म्हणलेला आहे primary source. For example, we know that sun, stars, tube light, all these are the primary sources. Then secondary sources, those sources which do not produce light of their own but receives light from the other source and either reflect or scatter it around. म्हणजे जे सोर्स आहे म्हणजे स्वतःची लाईट नसते, जे दुसऱ्याकडून लाईट रिसीव्ह करतात त्याला म्हणलेलं आहे सेकंडरी सोर्स. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, मून, प्लॅनेट्स, ऑब्जेक्ट लाईक मून, ॲनिमल्स, ऑल दीज आर द सेकंडरी सोर्स ऑफ लाईट. Then next one is that wavefront. What is meant by wavefront? Look at here. This is the source of light. The blue lamp indicates, this is a green line indicating that the source of light. And this yellow rays indicate that the rays travels all direction in a medium. At a particular point, eka particular point chatikani, every stereo posted at some time distance. त्या वेळा त्या ठिकाणी त्या सर्व रेजमधले जे पार्टिकल्स आहेत, जे पार्टिकल आपण ह्या ठिकाणी एक इनवलोकस ड्रॉ केलं, तर त्या लोकसमधले सर्व पार्टिकल्सचे व्हायब्रेशन्स आहेत. हे व्हायब्रेशन्स एका स्पेसमध्ये आहेत, म्हणजे ऑल दिस पार्टिकल्स व्हायब्रेट इन अ सेम फेज कॉल्ड ॲज द फ्रंट. ओके, that means as the locus of all the parts of the medium to which the wave reaches simultaneously, so that all the points are in the same phase or the wavefront. Then we know that there are first is that the spherical wavefront. Here this is the circular ring, looks like circular ring. This is spherical circle, that is circular ring is the wavefront. This is the spherical wavefront. Spherical, what is meant by spherical wavefront? Consider this is the point source as the light waves are emitted by it and travels in all possible direction. If c is the velocity of light, upon a supposition, where c is the velocity of light, then after time t, each wave will reach surface of the sphere of radius ct with center S. म्हणजे आफ्टर सम टाईम नंतर ज्या वेळेस ती वेव आहे फॉरवर्ड डिरेक्शन ट्रॅव्हल होईल, त्यावेळेस त्या ठिकाणी ह्या स्पिअरपर्यंत पोहोचेल. त्यावेळेस त्या ठिकाणी त्या स्पिअरची रॅडियस आणि सी टी असेल आणि सेंटर ऑफ स्पिअर. अँड दिस स्पेरिकल सरफेस इज कॉल्ड ॲज द स्पेरिकल वेवफ्रंट ॲट टाईम टी. plane wave front at a very large distance from the pond. So the spherical wave front is so large that a small part of it is almost a plane. This part is called as the plane wave front. Where the point P considered as the point source, and this point source, you will know that the point source is the spherical wave front. That means that if we have point P, we know the spherical wave front, so the initial part of the spherical wave front. After some time, when the spherical wave front goes to the forward direction, then it will become a plane wave front. Cylindrical wave front. If the source of light is linear, that is a slit, it produces cylindrical wave front. That means the linear source is the cylindrical wave front. Then next point is that the wave normal and a ray of light perpendicular drawn to the surface of the wave front at any point is called as the wave normal. This red circular lane is the spherical wave front. The rapanhaticani have a wave front where the rapani perpendicular drawn to it. The teacher circular wave front is 90 degree measure and that wave front. And the wave front, the ray ahe tala samjalela ahe, wave normal la samjalela ahe. Called as the ray of light. This is the direction of the propagation of light at that point. This indicates that the direction of propagation of light at that point, direction in which the light travels, is called the direction. That means in which the light travels is called as a ray of light. A wavefront, wave normal is similar to that of the ray of light.